You know, I kind of wait for things to happen in life, and I kind of collect stories along the way, and I try to use them to illustrate either really good things that happen, or sometimes things that are not so happy or positive, and I try to teach by stories, and my kids hate them. I'm sure my staff are tired of blowing out stories, and I have a bank of them, and I can bring them out for illustrations. But one of them, the ones that I know of, is that being an RA at Kansas State University or working in housing has a wide reach. And you never, never know when you're going to bump into somebody and you start connecting the dots. And why are you wearing purple? I went to K-State. Well, what did you do? And it's before long you recognize that you probably had a similar position. Maybe you lived in the same hall. Maybe you were a staff member in the same building. But it's so, so small. And that, you know, I was trying to calculate, we probably have had 4,000 or 5,000 resident assistants, you know, since the early 60s at K-State. But when you look around at how impactful all of you have been, you've made a lot of differences in communities and in hometowns. And so the story I'm going to tell is about a friend of mine who's a hall director at Haymaker Hall, Todd Clark. He can't be here today, but he lives in Virginia. He's like an assistant dean of students at a very small school. And he came to, he's a, getting his PhD at the University of Nebraska. Not a great choice, but okay. They're not our rivals any longer. We get a couple more years to play them and go back and forth, and then they'll go get beat up in Big Ten country. Well, so Todd, he has to spend 3 weeks here to do his residency, and so he was coming from Virginia, and he was staying at a house in Lincoln, and so he was making connections with all of us that are still here in Manhattan to come and visit us. So the first weekend he came, and we had a stay with Chad and Don, and we went golfing, and we played. He played on our softball team. He did perform well, had a great time. And, he actually drove down later in that week and played another night game with us on our softball team. And the following week was Memorial Day weekend, and he was going to come down, and we were going to golf and stuff like that. And I call him up and said, Todd, I can't golf again this weekend. You know, I've got my neighbor's cows are in our field, and I've got to fix our fence. So I'm going to be fixing fence all weekend. He said, I'll help. So Todd came down and spent all weekend, actually one long day, fixing fence. He didn't know how to fence, so I gave him the job of driving the steel stakes, you know, on the fence posts. And he did about 100, which if you've ever driven, that's a lot.
That's a lot.
He was worn out. He could hardly move. But the story that I'm trying to get to, which I haven't gotten to yet.
Long way to go.
So he's on his way back home to Lincoln, driving really fast. What should happen is that the tax collectors in Lincoln, or short of Lincoln, decide they want to tax him a little bit and say he's speeding too much. So a highway patrolman turns on the lights and flags him down. He's doing like 85. So he's getting ready to pay a lot of money to the state of Nebraska. So this highway patrolman says, please join me in my car, which I'm not sure why you would do that. So they start, he said, sir, why are you driving so fast this late at night? He said, well, I was down visiting friends in Manhattan. So the police officer, the highway patrolman said, well, I'm from close by. I went to school in Lincoln, or in Manhattan. And so they start touching base, and this guy said, well, you know, why were you there in Manhattan? He said, well, I was connecting up with some old housing people, some people that I was, you know, on the staff with. And so really, you were working for housing, yeah? The highway patrolman said, well, I was an RA in Marlin Hall. And they started connecting the dots, and he was an RA in the mid-90s. And one of the assistant hall directors is a friend of Todd's, and he says, I've lost connection with Dana Catania, and I want to be able to connect back with her. So before long, they're exchanging like Facebook and email and all that stuff. And he didn't get his tickets. So the point of the story, I think, is that you never know when you're going to make a connection with somebody that's doing something special and somebody that's there to help you no matter what you need. And I think that's why I've been blessed all these years with people that I know and have worked with that have been there to help you no matter what it is, if it's driving fence posts or cleaning up after floods or cleaning up after tornadoes. So the script says now I'm supposed to invite you, maybe not all of you, but a few of you, to share examples or stories of times when you've made connections with each other that you may not have really thought you were going to. So who would like to be first on a quick story?